Well, the right way to start a new month is with an update, right? So we have the new OxygenOS 10.5.8 update for OnePlus Nord that is being rolled out as of now. And I had literally a ton of comments from you guys in the past 15 days or so asking about the fixes of various issues that persist with the OnePlus Nord. Given that the hardware in general is quite capable, more or less, it is let down by some buggy updates that have ruined our overall experience. So in this video, let's have a look at the latest update for OnePlus Nord. First of all, like every update, please be patient for the OTA to come on your device. But if you are impatient just like me, you can flash this latest firmware via Oxygen Updater application from the Google Play Store. Once you have downloaded that, open the application and you will be notified that you have an update. So simply click on download and this will download the zip file of the update. Once it's done, the rest of the steps are simple enough. So go to settings, click on system, choose system updates from the list. Now click on this gear icon on the top right corner. Alright, now choose the zip file you just downloaded in step 1. So click on OK button and this will start installing the update. And no, it won't format your data, so you can give it a shot without worrying about it. But I will advise you to wait for the second part of this video, as you might end up with more bugs, and that is why even OnePlus rolls out these updates slowly to everyone, so that in case of any errors, less devices will be affected this way. Anyways, just let it install and then hit the reboot button. So there you go, you have finally booted to the latest OxygenOS 10.5.8 update on your OnePlus Nord. Now let's talk about the changes. So here is what the changelog looks like, and we do have some new features and fixes as well. Coming to the display first, well, as per changelog, the calibration has been improved with this update. So I know, you must be worried about that tint issue, right? Well, I did not notice any huge changes as such, as there was much less tint for me after the last update, and even from the day I purchased this device. So no problems in the display part as such, but you guys let me know what is the current state of your display in the comment section down below. Next, in the network part, the overall stability has been optimized, as some of you were facing dropouts while gaming and in general day-to-day calls and stuff. So I hope this update will fix all that for you as well. Though for me it was not even there, and I'll be posting an update if I find any issues really soon. So stay tuned and subscribe if you haven't already. Next, in the camera part, well, I was hoping to have improved image quality of the front facing camera, but it looks like only image stabilization has been improved with this update. And here are some quick samples from the rear facing camera that were taken before and after the update. Here are a few samples from the front facing camera as well, in case you wish to see it. Well, I see no improvements in the images after the update as of now. And that was expected, as OnePlus hasn't claimed anything like that in the changelog either. Coming to the system part, here we have a lot of improvements. First, the security patch has been bumped up to September 2020, which was much required, so that's good to have. Other than that, we have the silent notifications option now. So to activate that, you can go to settings, click on apps and notifications, now click on notifications, and in the advanced option, click on hide silent notifications in the status bar. So this will basically remove or hide the notifications from status bar that you will mark as silent. And these notifications won't bother you unless you turn them back on. So I appreciate the option and so will you. Apart from this, the long screenshot experience has been improved in some scenarios. And I used to see some glitches here and there while using that option. So that has been taken care of with this update as well. Last but not the least, the changelog states improved system stability and fixed known issues. And I hope it fixes that random formatting issue that some of you faced, and also the Bluetooth disconnection bug that used to exist with the previous versions. Though it has been fine for me most of the time, but I will still test it out thoroughly and let you guys know about my experience with it. Along with that, the battery backup and standby drain issues should have also been taken care of, though it is not mentioned anywhere in the changelog. So, you know, keeping my fingers crossed for that. And before I sign off, here are the quick benchmark scores before and after the update. So in the Geekbench, the OnePlus Nord used to score 627 in single core department and 1967 in the multi-core department before the update. And now after the update, the device scores 615 in single core and 1940 in multi-core department. So it seems like the score has dropped this time, and I did run the benchmark 3 times after restarting and clearing all the apps. So basically, these are all the changes that have been done with this update. And I'm really expecting all those previous issues to get fixed with this one. So let's see how it goes during the testing period. And that would be all for now. So do like this video if it helps you out and subscribe to the channel to stay notified. So I'll see you in the next one.